Hello, welcome to Tabletop CP. Tonight we return to the 29 Let's Go campaign. Game 3, Scenario 2, Delaying Action at Arthenay.
He was a famous trumpet man from our Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was a top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone with the draft.
So before we get into the briefing for tonight, just a quick summary of what's happened up to this point. So the Americans were finally able to break through at La Combe, thanks to Sergeant Padilla and his mad rush off the end. It was quite heroic. Meanwhile, Nils Westermann and his platoon of Germans have held the Americans for one turn at least. And they have not lost a single man, and they are in good spirits and looking to continue the fight. The mission for tonight is Scenario 4 from the rulebook, a delaying action. So in this scenario, a somewhat disordered defender is attempting to blunt the advance of a stronger attacker, which will be the Americans. So the Americans will be starting on this side. The Germans will be starting on this side. They have this outline in dice. This is their starting area. They have to place 3 patrol markers in that area. And the Americans have to place 4 patrol markers anywhere on their board edge. The Germans will have to place their patrol markers at least a minimum of 6 inches apart. So they're not going to be able to stack. So that's going to be interesting for Andre. And once the patrol phase is over, the Germans will place 2 jump off points. They will place a 3rd jump off point anywhere in their starting area. And the Americans will be placing 3 jump off points. For force support, the Americans will be getting 19 points, and the Germans will be getting 10 points, so quite a high number for a defender. But there is a rule. So the attacker in this has no restrictions on his support choices, so I can bring anything. The defender may not select entrenchment, static defenses, or preliminary barrage, so that's going to be rough for the Germans not to be able to bring any entrenchments at all, but they do have all these buildings here. The objective, to win victory, the attacker must capture one of the jump off points in the German starting area and hold it until the end of the turn. Any other result is a victory for the defender. The attacker will be the active player in the first phase of the game. So that's the mission. So the American platoon is trying to capture this little village of Arthenay so they can continue the advance on the bridge. Now we'll take a quick look at the terrain. So same terrain as usual for this campaign. The hedges do not block the line of sight, but you do have to be against them. So they are pretty close to true hedges. And so there's hedges here. There's a hedge here with an orchard in it. So a 6-inch visibility, well, doesn't really matter because the hedge is there. I've got some buildings. These are all hardcover. Got an interesting little piece of terrain here, which is a forest in the middle and surrounded by a hedge. So that'll be interesting. It looks like a pretty good strong point there. And then we got a shorter line of hedges back here. And that's it. The fields don't inhibit movement or anything like that. So that's it for terrain. And I guess we're ready to take a look at the forces. So here we have the American platoon. So these guys will be attacking. Your standard setup is with every other game in this campaign. So we start off, we got Lieutenant Greg Ward back. He's gonna bring a new platoon in and try it again. He's armed with the carbine. We also have Sergeant Jesse Mixon coming back with his SMG. So both of these guys played the very first game in this campaign. They couldn't quite pull it off. They got pretty close, but in the end, they couldn't pull it off. So moving on to the rest of the platoon, we have a bazooka, and we have 3 identical squads. Each squad is a sergeant with submachine gun, an 8-man or 9-man rifle team, and then a 3-man BAR team. But what I did was I took for 1 support point the extra BARs. So each squad gets an extra BAR. So you make a 4-man BAR team with 2 BARs, and you take 1 man out of the rifle team. So now they're 7-man rifle teams and 4-man BAR teams, and they still are commanded by the junior leader. And we also have to bring a Sherman for 6 points out of the 19, so there it is. And that is my starting force. And I think that's about it. So Ward, Ward's 28 years old from Maine, a high school graduate. He showed aptitude in training and was selected to OCS. So he's a real go-getter, real intelligent guy. And then we got Sergeant Jesse Mixon. He's 25 from Sacramento. He's a hustler. If it can't be found, then it can't be had because he can find everything. Before the war, he was a door-to-door encyclopedia salesman. So there you go. You never know what people are going to turn into when war hits. So now we'll go take a look at the German platoon. Here is the defending German platoon. This is the rifle platoon from the 29 Let's Go campaign. So in command, we still have Lieutenant Nils Westermann, a strapping 6 foot 21-year-old from Frankfurt, from a middle-class home. His father's service in the First World War earned Nils a commission. And Nils' main objective at this point of the war is to get as many of his men home safely as possible. The rest of the platoon consists of one Panzerschreck team and three identical squads. Each squad is a sergeant with submachine gun, a four-man LMG team with three crew, one rifleman, and then a five-man rifle team. And each squad, I believe, has one Panzerfaust. So let's talk real quick about our squad leaders. So first of all, we got first squad here. The green base, that is Conrad Becker. He's a remarkably overweight drunk from Dusseldorf and a degenerate drunk, former cabaret musician. Okay, that's first squad there. Second squad, the blue disc, that is Wilhelm Schneider, a strapping 6 foot 23-year-old from Saarburg, a rural farm boy. He left the Hitler Youth to join the army. And his squad, or he, I should say, won an Iron Cross second class in game one of this campaign when he blew up that Sherman that was about to win the game for the Americans. Then finally, the yellow base, we have Adolf Fischer, a tall and thin 21-year-old from Berlin. He's from the inner city and his father worked at an armaments factory. So there you go, there's our three squad leaders and our platoon leader. And that is it for the forces. So I guess I should real quick talk about CO's opinion. So as far as this platoon goes, it's the only persistent platoon in the game. The Americans get a free or a fresh platoon every single game. So the men's opinion are plus three. So they haven't lost a man. I don't know if they've lost a man wounded at all. Definitely not killed. And then the CO's opinion's at plus one. And Nils himself is worried. But he does get plus one on his force morale roll. So the Americans, on the other hand, Colonel Good is nervous. I believe if he drops one more level, he will start stalling, and I'll have to get one of the division commanders down here to light a fire under him. So that is it for the forces. So when Andre gets here, we'll do all our pregame stuff, and then we'll get started. All right, Andre's here. I briefed him. Now we will roll for force morale. I got an eight again.
Well, that's how that goes.
You got a seven, because you got plus one on your force morale. Because your men's opinion, but I'm starting at an eight, which is not good. So
now we started at 12.
Yeah, you started at 12. I started at eight, and
it's a fair fight.
We'll do the patrol phase, and then pick support into our plan. I wound up with one here, one right there behind the hedge, and then one over there towards the edge of the board on the hedge. Andre placed two, placed one in that building there, one behind the building.
And the one in the
objective. And the objective area is that building there, or that jump off point. So that is it for the patrol phase. Now we'll let Andre pick his support. I'll pick mine. We'll do our plans. We'll get started. So American plan. So I wound up with a jump off point here. One here and one there. So that one over there and this one here are the two that I need for my plan. So over here is going to be my base of fire. So I'm going to bring my mandatory Sherman and park it here. And from here he can cover a lot of this stuff. I mean, almost everything, even these back hedges here. I'm also going to have one of the squads, and then I'm bringing a 60 mil mortar, and then I'll bring a senior leader over here. So that whole group will provide covering fire this direction. And if the situation presents itself, they will start moving up. And over here is going to be my attack element. So I'm going to have the other two squads, a 50 caliber machine gun, which is a support I'm bringing. Also a flamethrower team and a medic. So I'm going to have Sergeant Mixon with his SMG, two squads, flamethrower team, and 50 cal. Try to move up this way. Shouldn't be too hard since he doesn't have any jump off points up this far. So I should be able to advance right up to here. Probably no problem. And once I get here, I don't know what I'm going to do. Probably send scouts out, try to make him deploy. Use the two squads to support the flamethrower and move up and try to burn him out. But ultimately, I got to get over there to get the objective. So that's my plan. So now I'll go ahead and see what the Germans are going to do.
Okay, so the German plan here is pretty straightforward. We are in cover. Travis has to come to us. And, really all I know for sure, if I was Travis, I would be sticking some heavy artillery down at the far end on that hedgerow covering the upper stories of these buildings. Given that, I'm assuming I'm not going to be able to deploy into the buildings effectively. I'm also thinking that this is going to be Travis's jump off hedgerow, and it's going to be from here that he's going to launch his assault, which means there's a pretty good chance I'm going to lose that jump off point before I even deploy anything, which means I'm primarily deploying off of this rear jump off point and possibly over in this building, which could actually work if I got that blocking cover and I've got a very limited line of fire across. It's possible I could get a decent crossfire here, or at least just enough fire to suppress his assault. I don't really see me winning this one, mostly because I'm more than likely going to have to pull out as soon as he starts getting an upper hand, or it looks like he might, which could happen very easily. I don't want to get caught by a double phase and wind up losing 5-6 guys. I've got an intact force at the moment, and I'm gonna try and keep it that way for at least this game. So Travis might be able to pull this one off without too much resistance from me, but we'll see. If I see an opening, I've been known to change my mind, so we'll see.
Both plans are complete, and the Americans, the attackers, take the first phase. So a 5, 2 threes, and a 1. Brought in my Sherman 6 inches off the road, and I also brought in a rifle team, or a whole squad actually, BAR rifle team and the 60 millimeter mortar. So now it is the German phase.
And woo!
Bunch of stuff. See if Andre brings anything in. Andre's gonna pass, so that's a lot of stuff, but no fives. My tank moved over this direction, and with the I brought the lieutenant in, Lieutenant Ward. Everyone's on overwatch, and then I brought two squads in here, and one of them went on overwatch, and
that's you got it. A good defensive position there, Travis.
Yeah, we'll see if we can hold it.
Okay, here comes the attack, and pass.
Double phase.
But I got a 5.
Another 5.
Woohoo!
Burn them up. Burn up the double phases.
Ooh!
3 more.
Yeah.
Man, you're going to have a lot of... So you're almost... Damn, man.
And a 2. I'll pass.
Come on, man. Bring a squad in. All right, we're just going to go right on over here. Don't like moving too much with the camera, but... Oh, end of turn.
Oh, no.
Damn, and a 4 and a 2.
So that ends your pregame garage, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah. None of us can take pregame barrages in this one. Neither side has it, which is crazy.
So you didn't tell me that. I was sure you had one.
Yeah. The two, I just moved those guys up and move on to the next phase. All my Overwatch came off. Another double phase. Okay, I got the three, the four, and the two. Oh, with the three, the tank moved up. The four, the Lieutenant Ward just put everyone over here on Overwatch. And with the two, the squad moved up and German phase. Sorry, double phase again. So we're going to actually do the first phase after the double phase. We'll do full dice. And then the phase, if you get a second double phase, we'll start dropping. So down to four. Another five. A four and a three. I just put my tank on Overwatch. Another five.
Another five.
You're almost up to your third chain of command dice, and then.
Yep. Then I can start ambushing.
Really good roll.
Ooh.
On that's passing. Another five. There we go. A one, a couple threes, and a four. One, I brought the 50 cal team in here. And the. That's pretty much it. With a three, this squad moved up to the hedge. Remember here, I got my base of fire all on Overwatch. And your go, Andre.
Yeah.
All right. So a full chain of command dice. And a one on this fourth and final one. And then a two, three, and a
two,
four.
Two, three, four. You're...
Another double phase.
Thank you. Get on up here.
Anxious. Three and a one. 50 cal ran up, so actually it takes a point of shock. And then the squad went on Overwatch. Now next phase. Ooh, three fives. I got my chain of command die. And a four and a three. Man, I need some more ones.
That's all I'm gonna do.
Another chain of command point.
Go for it.
Two, two, three, four.
So I'm not doing anything. I'm waiting for the proper roll.
So can we just max out my, how about we say I got a chain of command dice and you get your roll. Okay, I can bring in a senior leader, second phase. I'm up to five and I didn't get a one and a four either.
All right, my go?
Yeah.
Still no ones. Damn, but two more chain of command points. A two and a four, yeah. I get what I need here.
Travis knows me too well. He knows I'll counterattack any second here. I just need a double phase.
And you finally got your fourth chain of command dice, okay.
Okay.
So that's it for you and chain of command dice. So next double phase.
I'm trying to figure out if I'm going to ambush with something.
Okay. He's not ambushing. Now you got to drop one.
I don't know why I'm even rolling pass.
Damn, still no ones. What the hell's going on here? Yeah, I cannot move until I get a one.
It's your turn.
Okay, so Andre can't get anything, so...
We're in new territory here.
No ones, but I did get a double phase.
Woohoo!
Actually, yeah, I gotta do it this way. Still no ones. What the hell, man? All right, your phase. Oh, my phase. We're all waiting on a one. There it is. All right. And another double phase. And a chain of command point.
So you can actually go now?
I can go now.
Whew.
My flamethrower came in. I believe that's my last point of support. The Sherman, the 50 cal, the mortar, the BARs. Oh, my medic. I got to bring my medic in. All right. So next phase. All right. So I'll bring my medic and my last senior leader... my platoon sergeant in. Mixon came in along with the medic. He ordered the flamethrower up, and that's it. So German phase. So Andre's just gonna wait. Another five. Catching up to you now, Andre.
We both should have just started with four dice.
So I've made it up. Everyone's in position. Those guys ran over there. Everyone's moved up, and I'm pretty much ready to spring my plan. So you gonna roll?
Go.
I know you like rolling dice, so I just want to make sure.
Yeah, well...
Another chain of command point. Two twos and a three.
So I brought in.
Probably can't put the rest of those guys back on.
Those guys are on Overwatch over there, aren't they?
Oh, all of them?
Yeah.
Okay.
Except for the mortar. Okay, so I sent scouts out. They only made it right across. Put the BAR team on Overwatch. Put the 50 cal on Overwatch.
Go ahead.
So Andre is just. I could probably just not even film and just get to the point where we're about to start shooting. That'll save some time. But people might want to see the command roll, so...
They might be curious how you got there without me being able to react.
Move my scouts up. 2d6 tactically, American rule. And then the rusted rifle team on Overwatch. So everyone's on Overwatch everywhere. And scouts are advancing, and Andre is still lying in wait. Four fives. Man. So I'm about caught up to you, Andre, in a two... yeah, I'm not doing anything with the two, so you're not gonna do anything again?
Let me think about it.
Andre's passing again. That scout team moving. I could do it with that.
Amy.
My scouts were able to move up and get within four, and that shut it down.
And Travis is accusing me of being gamey as he runs his scouts out here.
I'll tell you what Andre wanted to do. He wanted to deploy a machine gun right here and use my guys as human shields so I couldn't shoot back. Yeah, not happening. First of all, I can't get within four. Second of all, that's just gamey. Three more fives. Okay, Andre, I'm officially... Actually, I think I'm almost caught up to you. In a three and a four. Andre spent a dice to ambush an MG42. He's gonna fire at them. Eating fives, wow. Three, four, five, six, seven hits.
Woo-hoo!
Man.
And that's how you spring an ambush.
Yeah, that's a good one. Okay, so I got... I guess you want more on the BAR team, I'm assuming?
Sure.
Okay. Dead in the shock. And the rifles? Nothing. Check the leader. Not the leader. So a dead BAR and a shock. Just a dead in the shock there, Andre's phase. You're rolling the wrong dice there, Andre.
You say that like I've never done that before.
I guess it doesn't matter, as long as you can keep track of what's what. You got a one, you can fire your MG42 again, no?
And I can bring in a senior leader with him.
Good.
But
yeah, if you're in the open, you're in the open. You don't. It's not bolt action where 50% is in the cover, you get cover. If you're in the, if anyone's in the open, they get hit first, so... Plus, they're the only guys I can see.
I guess I should have brought one of the other sections and just set them without the...
Without the tripod mounter? Okay. So, I'm shooting back, needing fives.
Actually, shit. These guys aren't...
One, two, three, four, five, six. Six hits, Andre. And they have to go on those two guys, I guess. But shock will spread. So, yeah, those two guys are dead, but you take, no, they're just dead. Just those two guys are dead. So you can shoot now. 10 shots, needing fives. Hopefully you don't get seven hits again. Actually, probably get less hits when do more damage. One, two, three. So two on the BAR, I'm assuming.
Yeah.
Dead in a shock. And a shock. Not the leader. There we go. Next phase for the Americans. Not too bad. Before anything, do anything, Andre is going to interrupt and fire again with this machine gun.
Fives?
Fives.
Only four.
All right, come on. Four BAR sixes. Team. Point of shock. And rifle team. One dead. It's the leader. He takes a wound. So the leader takes a wound. Bad thing happens. I think I'm going to use my dice to skip that.
Okay.
Did you do that?
Yeah.
Actually, my platoon sergeant's attached. I got to see if that wound is actually on him or the... So it was on him.
Ooh.
So Mixon took a wound. So he's down to two commands.
Did you do your bad thing already?
I skipped it, remember?
Oh. Good call.
I definitely would have skipped it more if it was Yeah, because if it's a junior, it's like 50-50, you might lose one, but...
Yeah.
Okay, so now... So I still got 2 threes, a 4, and a 1 left. All right, so with the wounded Mixon, I took 2 shock off. And then with the squad leader here, I took another shock off, and they're going to fire. But at first, Andre kindly reminded me that I have a mortar over there. I can fire the... Use the 1. So the mortar at these guys, needing 5s. I didn't get 1. So good job, Andre. The dice gods were kind to you that time.
Yeah.
So here we go. Firing back at the machine gun. 1, 2, 3, 4 hits.
Did you subtract dice for your shocker?
I got down to 1 each.
So how many? 5?
4.
4. That's enough.
A dead and 2 shock. So they break. Oh no.
No.
You're just
we're
hanging
good,
in there.
We're good.
So you lost 1 guy. Yeah, one more shock and you're going to break. And your phase, Andre. I guess, well, hold on a second here. I do have a 3 left, but yeah, I'm not going to do anything right now. I'm going to win this firefight first. Hey, building your chain of command dice back up. And no 1.
That's important. Okay.
Nothing?
I could bring a senior leader in to help those 2 dudes out.
Yeah, you could.
I don't see that happening.
Okay. Another 1 from my mortar. So I was about to fire the mortar, but immediately Andre burned another chain of command dice and just... what's it called? Interrupt.
Interrupted.
He just moved around the corner.
Moved out of sight. We're going to fire at them, but they disappeared.
Yes. Throwing the shock, moved them up. 50 cal moved over to the far end. And I think that's pretty much it for me. Couple more 5s. 2 1s and a 4. They're just going to sit tight with his MG42 behind the building. 2 more 5s. I'm actually ahead of you now, Andre. 1 4 and a 3. Before, I just moved Mixon over. Put the 50 cal on overwatch. The squad moved up with a 3. And with the 1, that scout team that was there ran into the bottom 4. Your turn, Andre. Or your phase. No 5s.
No 5s.
And then Andre's debated a bit, and he decided he's not going to do anything because of my tank, basically. Double phase. Another 5, a 2, and a 4. So this squad just advanced with the 2 up to there. With the 4, I used Mixon. He had the squad move over. They rolled a double 6, so they were able to get over. And he also had the flamethrower advance up to the hedge. Oh, a double phase. Forgot about that. Oh, man.
Don't forget your double phases.
Another double phase. End of turn. Obtain a command point and a 4. All I have is a 4, so Mixon we had the flamethrower jump over and join us, and that is it. And I will now drop a die, because it's the 3rd of the double phases. Another chain of command points. 1, 4, and a 2. The squad just moved up, flamethrower moved up with them. On the 4, the 1, the guys that were on the bottom floor here moved up to contact the jump off point. And that's all I can do. Sadly. Double phase.
Oh, damn it.
2, 3, 4. Andre's going to deploy from this jump off point. He can get into the building. He's going to pop out behind the furniture and kill those scouts. So, I know I'm going to die, but I'm going to get 3 dice. So I'm just going to roll them. Because I know I'm pretty sure you're going to get a 5. 2 5s on however.
10 plus.
A lot of dice, yeah. But I can see if I can kill some of your guys. Ooh. 2. 2 die.
Wow.
Check your leader.
Check my leader.
My own leader. Oh, it is him.
Oh, man.
That's Fisher. He's killed. Oh, my God. Fisher really? Is killed in the melee.
Really?
Poor Fisher.
Fisher and one other dude are out.
Fisher and one other dude are dead.
Nice.
And I'm dead. So roll a bat thing, unless you want to ignore it.
Man.
5. 5. Junior leader killed. -2.
Down to 9.
And I'm not going to spend mine, or should I? Yeah, I'm going to spend another one to ignore it. Well, I don't know. You still got another phase, don't you?
Yep. It's the worst that can happen.
Team wiped out. As long as I don't roll a 6. Actually, team wiped out. The max is a 1, so yeah, I'll just roll it up. So that's a minus 1.
Yep. Down to 7.
Down to 7.
Weren't you? Oh, yeah. Down to 7.
You're down to 9, all right? So you've taken the building.
Okay.
Andre moved that team out, the platoon leader, Westermann, Festerman. So he took the 2 shock off, had them move. I'm going to interrupt with my BAR team. Needing 4s. There's only 2 guys left there, and they're in the open. Not a 1 hit. Oh my god, that's a whiff. That is a whiff.
Okay, exactly. So it's officially a whiff.
Oh my god. All right. Woo. That did not work out at all. I knew I shouldn't have done that. I knew I was going to whiff. All right, so.
Well, even if you hadn't, I'm not sure it was.
Yeah, but I'm down to 1 left.
Shot,
I got a. Man, okay.
And I got another team coming.
I should have just moved them, actually, out of the way, but whatever. And Andre still has another squad that he can bring in. Andre brought another team in, or another squad. So he's got 1 squad left, plus whatever support he has. And he's going to fire at those guys that just failed their ambush, or their interrupt.
Well, the 4s didn't help.
So 2 hits.
3. 2 sixes and a 5.
Okay, 3 hits. 3 hits. So I guess I'll spread them. So I got a flamethrower team, I got a rifle team, and I got a. You had 3 hits?
Yeah.
Alright, BAR team. That's a dead BAR. Flamethrower. Nothing. Rifles. Nothing. So leader. Nope. So a dead BAR team, and that's it. And I think that's it for Andre's phase, so he'll have to take his second phase. So, all I did was I lost a BAR man, and I'm going to end the turn with my last chain of command dice, which he loses this jump off point, so roll a bad thing, Andre, unless you want to ignore it.
Well, I was thinking about that, and I'm going to go ahead and roll it. I think that's 2.
Yep. Minus 2, so we're tied now.
We're tied at 7.
Yes, all right.
And I'm going to continue.
Okay.
I was thinking seriously about pulling out here. It probably is the right move, but I got Travis in my sights, and I want to do some damage.
Even though it doesn't matter.
Oh, nice.
I get fresh platoons.
Yeah, but so there's 2 plus 1.
So he's back up to 2 and 1, and then he wound up with a 2 and a 4. Andre's going to... So the commander had the squad move downstairs. He put them on overwatch, and he's going to make them fire the machine engine. Hitting 4s with an 18. 2 hits.
A Travis roll.
Yeah.
A travesty.
Seems like it. VAR team. Rifle team. So a shock on the BAR.
Wow. A German machine gun in the open, short range. I put a shock on you.
Yep. Hey, that makes up for the crappy roll I had earlier.
No, my last crappy roll made up for that.
All right. So that's my phase. All right, here we go. And I'm out of chain of command dice. But I'm closing in on another one. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, to begin with, the platoon sergeant, Mixon, moved himself back to here, and he ordered the 50 cal over to here. They took a shock because they moved with all 3, but they are now within line of sight of those guys. And with the 3, I'm going to fire the tank into this building.
So how many? So that's
6, 18, 6.
What, what do you need?
4s to hit, and it reduces cover by 1. So be a soft cover hit on 4s with 6 dice. So he's going to take the shot. So I need the 4s with the main gun. 1, 2. Okay. Soft cover.
2 soft ones.
No, nothing. And then the machine gun. One, two, three, four. But hardcover for the machine gun.
Four hard ones.
Dead in the shock. So another dead. Not your leader though, right? Because you're already, oh no, your senior leader's in there. Ooh, Westermann's in there. You don't want to get him hit.
Nope.
So a dead guy in a shock. And that was the tank. So the one I'm gonna fire the mortar at the squad here. Leaving fives. One hit, so one hit on the machine gun squad. In the open. Dead. Check him. See if it's him. No. That could have been Becker, the fat drunk from Dusseldorf. And so that was a one, a three, a four. I got a two left. So I was going to fire the BAR team at them, but he's going to interrupt. And he's going to fire shots. Nine shots. Yeah, nine shots.
Needing fours?
Threes. Three hits.
Threes?
I'm sorry. Fours, yeah. Three hits. I see three hits there. Never hit on threes. I think actually, I don't know. I think if you're going against green, I think that just makes them easier to kill. I don't know. Maybe, I don't know. We never play green. So one on the BAR team. Oh, no. The flamethrower. And the rifles. So a dead BAR. Just a dead BAR team. Okay, now I'll fire. So I'm just going to fire.
Shock on your rifles.
Shock?
You had a three.
Okay, put a shock on them then. So I got two BARs left. And I need fours.
Does it diminish your firing at all that I got rid of all your loaders?
I don't have loaders. BARs don't have loaders. So three hits on you, but you can split them because you got that machine gun team there next to you.
Okay.
So you can do one, one, and one.
Okay, machine gun.
Nothing. Dead machine gun. Rifles. Nothing. Check your leader again. Oh! It's Becker. See what happens to him. He's wounded. Lightly wounded. So, bad thing. And junior leader wounded. Minus one. So he's down to six. And he didn't lose a man. Just took a wound on Becker, and yeah. So you can fire your Overwatch now, though.
Overwatch back at you.
Okay.
Nine shots again, right?
Ten.
Ten shots.
Ten shots, yeah. Tripod mounted.
Ten shots. Ten shots at you, needing twos.
Yeah. You wish.
I fours.
Do.
Ooh, fours are paying off. Threes would have been really awesome. Four hits.
Four hits. Okay, so I'm assuming you can only see the machine gun and the BAR, or the flamethrower and the BAR.
Yeah.
So flamethrower, nothing.
Nice.
BAR, one dead. Check the leader. Nope. So another dead BAR, so I'm down to one BAR. And that's it.
And it's my roll.
Yeah, I think that was the two. Yep. So you're a go, man.
All right, I'm out of here.
Pulling out?
Yeah.
All right, we'll figure out what happens. All right, so Westermann has withdrawn. He's out of here. He's left Arthenay to the Allies. So we calculated up all the post-game stuff. So Westermann himself is still worried. His outlook didn't change. His men's opinion dropped too, though. They were not happy with Fisher being killed, and they lost another man, so they've dropped down to plus one.
Actual casualties? What yeah. is this?
The CO, technically, after the second battle of the campaign, Westermann is supposed to be cut off from Schwartz, the CO, due to an artillery strike on Isigny. So we're going to leave it at plus one. He's not going to be able to change the CO's opinion at all until he reestablishes contact. So basically, it does nothing. He just can't gain any benefit or lose support for pissing off Schwartz. He did lose one man killed in action. Two were going to be returning for the next the game after next, which doesn't matter because the next game is a fresh platoon on a different map. So Westermann's platoon won't be seen again for the next two turns at least, assuming I win the next one. And Colonel Good, he won, so his outlook actually goes up one automatically. He is now worried. which takes him out of the danger zone. He's now back in the white, so if he has one game to spare before he needs to call up Coda or the division commander. And again, Fisher was killed, the guy from Berlin, sadly. The 21-year-old guy from Berlin, his armament factory working father, is going to be upset because Westermann is going to have to write a letter to him. And that's it. Yeah, so American victory. Andre, I think, wisely pulled out. Especially with this 50 cal coming over here, it was about to start tearing you up a little bit.
Well, even without that, I was pretty sure that I was not going to, that I was going to be pulling out here.
Yeah. Okay, so what's, real quick, what's this, what was your plan, Andre?
My plan was to stay out of the buildings because I knew you were going to target them.
Right.
And to wait for you to come through and just see when I got an advantage, whether it was a, you know, a double phase when you were kind of spread thin, or I honestly wasn't sure if I was going to lose one or both jump off points before I deployed, but I saw an opening and it was like, you know,
it's, you did good by, because if you didn't put that machine gun out, I would have just ran those scouts 3D6 and I would have shut both of these down.
Which I was actually prepared for that to happen. I mean, I knew that was not an unreasonable expectation. It wouldn't have taken, you know, if you'd have gotten a double phase there, I'd have been, well, actually, I interrupted with it.
Yeah.
So it was, yeah, it was a, either I make a stand here or I've got to make my stand back here. And I just didn't want to limit my options that much.
Plus, if you lost both of these, I could get into both these buildings and have my base of fire. You would be, there's no way. You would be in trouble.
No, the way you were approaching this, I knew, I didn't see that I was going to be able to pull this off unless I got extremely lucky or you got really unlucky.
Yeah, so my plan was, well, establish your base of fire, the tank, a squad, the mortar, and Lieutenant Ward commanding everyone. And they were covering, I mean, I could see all of this. I could see the front of that. And the HE could see all of these buildings. So I knew I was going to be able to just, if you popped up anywhere, my base of fire was going to be able to do something. And then over here, I wasn't really quite sure what I was going to do. I didn't want to get the 50 cal up. I should have never moved them. I think that's the only reason you popped up, because I moved my 50 cal out of the way.
Well, yeah, I was trying to figure out as you advanced where I could come out and have you in the, you know, basically blocking line of fire. You know, I was looking for positioning for you being human shields and me being able to get shots off. And I was actually surprised I was able to shoot as many times as I did.
Well, a lot of those were interrupts, too, though.
No,
we went through a lot of chain of command dice in quick succession
that.
There.
I was also really surprised at how little damage I did with all of that. It just really didn't affect you much.
Yeah, I lost five guys and a wounded platoon sergeant. But I had actually plus my force morale was plus one against yours, so I lost four, which technically would have been two dead and one wounded.
Yeah, but I mean, all of that was, I fired at you a lot.
You did. And you whiffed, and I got good rolls, and then I whiffed, so it was...
Well, and then you got my...
it was bad shooting both ways.
Well, when I tried to come out at the end, I was hoping to drop some grenades on you, because dropping grenades out of windows is usually fairly effective.
Yeah.
And between that and having the two machine guns on the side, you weren't in a good spot there until you got your machine gun moved back down. But for a turn there, when I had that double phase, it's like, I can't pass this by. If I get some good rolls, I can really put a hurt on you and might actually even be able to push you back.
Yeah, and my interrupt shooting back was a complete whiff. I would have been better off just moving them.
Oh.
But I thought, man, I could take out that MG team. He has to roll a bad thing.
Yeah.
I knew I was going to end the turn and take that before you were able to move up and recap it.
Yeah.
And that was another. So you lost two on that. I mean, you went down from 11 down to 6.
And I should have... spin a die. I just didn't do the math quite right on when to burn my...
The second that you would have burned that, my tank was going to start rolling. Because I sadly already know that there's the two mortars out there, but that force... And it, you were talking about bringing your third squad in. I'm like, oh man, if that happens, these guys are going to start marching forward. So I was fairly confident in this one because mainly because you couldn't take any entrenchments. If you could pop up in hard cover, that's a different game at that point. Yeah. And I never got to fire my flamethrower, but never got to fire the 50 cal. I really didn't fire a whole lot
no.
in this game, tell you the truth.
You really didn't. I just, you got a couple key hits in a couple key places. And
Fisher, poor guy, have to raise one to him later. So
yeah.
Anyway, so the Americans won this one, and we're going to move on to map 3 in the next game, and that will be a fresh platoon. That'll be actually Lieutenant Kopke is going to be taking over that platoon. So that'll be his first chain of command action. Jens is one of our patrons. So speaking of that, check out our Patreon page if you want to see what's going on here behind the scenes and get some bonus content. And also check out our Facebook group. A lot of good guys on there posting a lot of cool stuff. And that's pretty much it for this one. So any last words, Andre, Steve, anyone... have any words of wisdom to...
My wisdom poor is, Fisher. What does Steve have to poor say?
Fisher. Poor Fisher, yes. We'll have to raise a toast to Fisher tonight. The fat drunk somehow escaped kills. Escaped
don't
getting killed.
Always?
Yeah. Because they're like limp. They go ragdoll and fly through the windshield. Night. Anyway, all right. So that's it for this one. So thanks for watching, guys. And we'll see you next time.